understand this?
Per la loro capacità di iniziativa.
How about this?
Silvana.
Buonasera Alessandra.
And this?
Wie heißt das Wort, das ich meine?
Okay, just one more.
Suite aux analyses lundi, un diagnostic.
Last one, I promise.
Извините, здесь туалет.
No, you tell me. Aren't you glad that you speak English? Speaking English allows us to communicate with people from different countries. Yeah, different nationalities. It is safe to say that English brings people together. Hello everybody, I'm Erica Belmonte, and if you're looking for great content to help you improve your English faster and better, well, my dear, you are the right place. But you know, before we get started, before we laugh and learn, just go ahead and click the like button and don't forget to subscribe to my channel because we have amazing content here every week. Are you ready? Okay, good, let's go. Well, globalization is serious, and with the internet, we're only a few clicks away from chatting with somebody in another part of the world. Because of that, we must know a little bit about different countries, about different nationalities, and also cultures, right? Here I am to brief you with a lot of unnecessary knowledge as well. No, I'm just kidding. Jokes aside, I believe you are going to learn a lot today. And when I say a lot, I mean a lot. Are you ready for some trivia? Did you know that there are only 3 countries in the world that don't use the metric system?
Erica, why do I care?
Because, my little pupil, if you come to a country that doesn't use the metric system, you be screwed and you won't know if you're going or coming. Well, most of the countries in the world use the metric system when describing things like length, depth, height, volume, temperature, and so on. Except for Liberia, Myanmar, and the United States. Yeah, that's right. In the US, we use customary units, which are far from what we're used to. Some of the customary units are miles, feet, inches, pounds, ounces. The list is huge. Well, Tokyo is the world's largest city when it comes to population sizes. Next largest city is New Delhi in India and Shanghai in China. Well, in case you're wondering about São Paulo, well, this is the 4th. Okay, now let me give you some fun and interesting facts about our continents. From the largest in size to the smallest. First one is Asia. Asia's population is over 4 billion people. Billion in the singular form because we don't use for numbers, exact number, plural form, remember that? Most Asian countries have more than one language that is natively spoken. For example, more than 100 languages are spoken in the Philippines. More than 600 languages are spoken in Indonesia. And more than 800 languages are spoken in India. Well, the largest continent in the world includes nationalities such as Cambodian, Lao, Malaysian, Filipino, Vietnamese, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, Mongolian, and so on. Another fun fact is that in China, it is not uncommon to come across canned fresh air for sale due to air pollution. Well, Africa is the second largest continent in the world, both in size and population, with over 1 billion people who speak over 1,500 different languages. Again, let's learn about nationalities, but now in Africa. So some of the nationalities include Nigerian, Ethiopian, Egyptian, Moroccan, Angolese, and so many more. Trust me, there are 54 countries in Africa with over 3,000 different ethnic groups. I would be listing them for at least 30 minutes here. Fun fact, the shortest distance between Africa and Europe is only 14.3 kilometers of ocean, and the Nile in Egypt is the longest river in the world. Yeah, North America is pretty big. 579 million people. And in North America, people speak European languages such as English, Spanish, and French. Their favorite foods include apple pie, hamburgers, hot dogs, mac and cheese, fried chicken, Texas barbecue, nachos, and pasta. Well, I also want to give you the pronunciation, like a pronunciation tip here regarding a country here. The country that I'm talking about is Haiti. Yeah, Haiti is in Portuguese, but we say Haiti in English. Haiti is a Caribbean country in North America, and most people pronounce it wrong. So one more time, Haiti. Okay, Fun fact again, the longest street in the world is in Canada, stretching over to 1,896 kilometers from Toronto to Ontario. And Puerto Rico is home to the famous Piña Colada drink. Can you guess which is the biggest country in South America? That's right, Brazil. Yeah, with more than half of the continent's population, which by now is over 211 billion people. Billion? Não tem billion não, gente. Que isso? Million. Again, talk about nationality. So, South American continent is formed by Brazilians, Argentinians, Peruvians, Chileans, Bolivians, and many other different nationalities, speaking mostly Portuguese and Spanish. Again, we also have a fun fact here. The green anaconda, a native of the Amazon, is the largest snake in the world. And the statue of Christ the Redeemer in Rio de Janeiro was named one of the new seven wonders of the world. Okay, so what do we not know about Antarctica? Well, in fact, it is really cold in there. But did you know that Antarctica is the highest, driest, coldest, and windiest continent of all? There is no Antarctic time zone. Scientists from all over the globe who live there in stations are free to use their home time zone, since most of Antarctica experience 6 months of constant daylight in summer and 6 months of darkness in winter. So just imagine all these neighboring stations sharing data and resources on a daily basis. Well, Europe is the second smallest continent in the world, just behind Oceania. Well, despite its relatively small size, Europe is home to a diverse range of nationalities such as French, Spanish, Russian, German, British, Italian, Ukrainian, Polish, and so many more. So another pronunciation tip here, and now we're gonna talk about Tahiti. Take a look at the way we write this, but we say Tahiti, not Tahiti, which is in Portuguese, right? But in English is Tahiti. Well, I'm mentioning this because Tahiti belongs to France, which is in Europe. Europe's most visited tourist destination is not the Eiffel Tower or Big Ben, but Disneyland in Paris. And Mount Etna is the largest active volcano in Europe, located in Italy. So the continent is called Oceania, but we know there are so many countries inside of it. And one of them is Australia. And be careful, because we don't say Australia, Australia. No, Australia, Australia. Well, Australia has a population of 25 million people. And did you know that 90% of these people live on the coast? That's because there are large deserts in central Australia, so the majority of the population lives on the shores of the enormous country. By the way, have you ever seen the kind of animals that live in Australia? Yep, Australians have to put up with a lot. I don't think I could do it, to be really honest. Now that I gave you a lot of interesting facts that you can share with your friends at the bar or at work, and also got everybody situated in this big world we live in, I think it is time for something that you can use to step up your game. How about some idioms using different nationalities? And the first one is, it's all Greek to me. If something is Greek to you, it means it's beyond your comprehension, when we have no knowledge on a topic. So, for example, I tried to watch a TV show about physics last night, but I gave up. It was all Greek to me. Another one is, go Dutch. No, that doesn't mean that we are traveling to the Netherlands. We go Dutch when we go to a restaurant and split the bill among everyone who ate together. Well, we gotta be careful though, because some idioms imply certain things. So, for example, this implies that the Dutch are cheap. It's not true. For example, we went Dutch on the meal last night. Next one, talk for England. Again, you are not gonna become a representative for the Queen. If you see someone or you talk for England, it means that they talk for hours and hours, for days and days, non-stop.
Blah, 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 blah.
Like someone I know. This idiom describes someone as talkative, communicative. Like, Matt just talks for England and I can get a word in. One more, Irish courage. Personally, I know a few people who rely on Irish courage to do certain things. I think you have an idea what it is, right? Irish courage is when you need a little alcohol to give you courage to do something, or maybe the confidence that you need. Like maybe to call somebody out or even ask somebody out. So, for example, I think I'll have a glass glass of whiskey for Irish courage. Yeah, just before I ask that girl out. Come on, one more. Pardon my French, also known as excuse my French. We use this expression before or after we have said something rude. So, for example, a swear word. It is often used to excuse yourself when there's someone offended by your words. So, for example, pardon my French, but I think you're an a**hole. One more, take French leave. This one is really interesting because do you remember many years ago when England and France had a misunderstanding? In France, they say to leave English style. Anyways, that means that you leave a party, a place, your work without permission or even saying goodbye. For example, the only thing that I could do was to take French leave before someone noticed me. One more, when in Rome, do as Romans do. But sometimes you can just stop it when in Rome and the person knows the rest. And this expression is very convenient. It means that you don't necessarily want to do something, but you feel obligated to do it simply because everybody else is doing it. For example, I don't love cotton candy, but we are at a carnival. When in Rome, right? Well, guys, that's it for today. Well, we had a lot of content. Probably some of the information that we had here was just more like extra info, like cultural information, but I really hope you have enjoyed that. You had learned a lot, like nationalities, countries, I don't know, anything that could be useful to you, and of course at the end some expressions in English. Well, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Well, in case you want to learn even more from me, I'm gonna leave all of the links here below and all my social media. Okay, so that's it for today and see you next time. Bye. Thank you.